This is Fox 31 News.
Guys, this is really cool. 7:44 this morning, we're joined by a rock climber from right here in Colorado, Tommy Caldwell. He completed the first ever free climb of the Dawn Wall of El Capitan in Yosemite National Park. If you don't know that wall, you've probably seen pictures of it. And to think that somebody would even climb it is absolutely bonkers. He was also at one point held hostage by rebels in Kyrgyzstan until he escaped. So what better way to document his life? He's got a book, The Push. You were up in Aspen talking about it yesterday. So the book came out, what was it, a year and a half, 2 years ago?
Yeah, almost 2 years ago
awesome.
Now.
Awesome. Yeah. So what made you think, I want to take all this stuff I've been through and write about it?
I mean, I've been a fan of adventure stories, yeah. An adventurer myself my whole life. So I, at some point, realized that I had some pretty dramatic stories to tell, and I should try and do it in book form. And I wanted to take that journey of, like, learning how to write a book and dive deep and really kind of, like, meditate. It was, like, my personal therapy experience.
Really? To take everything you've been through and kind of put it on paper is probably a lot more difficult than people think.
Yeah, I mean, it's a really introspective experience. I feel like I did it to, like, kind of, like, learn about myself.
Well, I'm watching all these pieces of video of you climbing. I mean, El Capitan, some people have called it the most difficult climb ever. And you took years to get ready for this.
Right. The Dawn Wall is the route that I ended up doing. And it is the, you know, technically the most difficult big wall climb in the world. And it was a 7-year process of trying to figure it out, train, and then, you know, a 19-day climb in the end.
So you're on a wall for 19 days?
Yeah, 19 days straight, living in portal edges.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah,
it's pretty. I couldn't even imagine it. And so what, you were held hostage by rebels. I know there was one guy guarding you. You ended up pushing him off a ledge at one point. What the heck happened there?
Yeah, that was sort of like this life inflection point, this very dramatic event in my life in 2000, where we were held hostage for 6 days, lost like 20 pounds in weight, very, very intense experience. And, you know, it changed me in so many ways. So that's kind of why I wanted to really meditate on my life, is to figure out how that really made me into the person I am today.
Well, and you talked too about how you were raised in Estes Park made you the person you are today too, in terms of like kind of prepping you to be a climber, right?
Yeah. I mean, I would say that prepped me for hardship, because my dad was taking me in the mountains and sort of toughing me up from a young age. And so in ways that prepared me for Kyrgyzstan, and everything adds on the last experience.
Now, do you have two kids? Do you raise them that way? How does that work?
I mean, kind of. I think I do tone it down a little bit. My dad was a bodybuilder, just like a huge personality. Yeah. And but I do. I mean, I think that I live in a community of people that are so energetic and so enthusiastic, and we travel the world and we climb these big mountains, and that's just cool. And I want my kids to experience that as well.
Cool. And all of these adventures you're talking about, all these crazy stories, this is all in the book?
Yeah.
It goes back to 2000.
Yeah, it's full life memoir.
Very cool. And what's next? I mean, you've done some crazy stuff. Do you slow down at some point?
I mean, I try to. But, I mean, I think that climbing is my food. I'm always doing that. I go to Yosemite for 6 weeks a year. I go on expeditions around the world. I'm also, you know, kind of getting into environmental activism these days.
Oh, cool.
As, you know, as many athletes are.
Well, yeah, you've been out there. You obviously live and breathe by nature and these parks.
And you see the changes, and it makes you want to do what you can to help.
Awesome. All right, so where can people buy the book if they want to read it?
You can buy it at your local bookstore, Amazon, or, you know, all the normal places.
Yep. The Push. Awesome. Yeah. Well, thank you, Tommy, for coming in.
Yeah.
It's fat. I mean, I'm kind of mesmerized just watching this crazy video. I mean, I get scared getting on my roof.
Yeah, as do most people.
I'm assuming you put up your own Christmas lights, right?
Yeah, and I never take them down. They're just up all the time. Yeah.
Oh, you're that guy. Oh, now we got to talk.
Yeah.
Thank you, Tommy.
Yeah, thank you.
Great to meet you. Yeah. Let's get over to Greg. He's watching your weather. Might be a decent day to get out there.